The 2011 Human Rights Report says there were 12 potentially unlawful fatal police shootings during the year under review, some reportedly committed by officers associated with an ad hoc task force within the police department. It was an obvious reference to reports of a so-called police death squad, with a reported hit list of criminal suspects, reports that have been denied by both the police and the former and current government. According to the U.S. State Department report, the Criminal Investigations Department conducted investigations and referred cases to the Director of Public Prosecutions for review. The report noted that the DPP reviews all police shootings resulting in death and refers matter for inquest. It disclosed that the 12 police shootings were all in varying stages of review, with three pending coroner's inquests. And while noting that the new Labour government took steps to expedite investigative processes and review of these cases, the Human Rights Report says there was only limited progress in the DPP reviews and other investigations of unlawful killings dating back to 2006. According to the Human Rights Report, authorities reported two police shootings from 2010 and one shooting from 2009 are still pending in the coroner's inquest process. Under the section of the Human Rights Report dealing with torture and other cruel, inhuman, or degrading treatment or punishment, the report notes that prisoners and suspects regularly complained of physical abuse by police and prison officers. It says there were also reports that police beat persons under arrest, either during the arrest or while in custody at the initial detention center prior to arrival at the prison. It says during the year, citizens filed a number of complaints against the police, most of which were for abuse of authority. And according to the report, on at least four occasions, police were alleged to have shot men during an arrest or during a neighborhood sweep operation. It says although the government sometimes asserted that independent inquiries would be launched into allegations of abuse, the lack of information created a perception of impunity for the accused officers. The U.S. Human Rights Report on Saint Lucia also says the procedure for investigating police officers was lengthy, cumbersome, and often inconclusive, so that when the rare cases reached trial years later, juries often acquitted, leaving an appearance of de facto impunity. For the DBS News World, Pete Ninval reporting.